Penguin Random House Audio presents The Hormone Shift. Balance your body and thrive through midlife and menopause. By Tasneem Bhatia, MD. Foreword by Gwyneth Paltrow. Read for you by Soneela, Nankani. With the introduction and epilogue read by the author. Note to listeners. This audiobook contains a bonus PDF with checklists, charts, illustrations, and an appendix from the book. Foreword. I was talking to Dr. Taz a couple of years ago about turning 50. She told me that she saw 50 as a culmination of the first part of our lives and an opportunity to reflect and decide how we want to live the next half. Taz described this chapter of our lives as the journey to becoming who you are, discovering your true soul, your essence, your purpose for being here. Taz's work as an integrative practitioner and hormone expert is so brilliant because her approach embraces the idea that, as she says, we're rising into our power and into our truth. And at the same time, she deeply understands that we need different kinds of support to navigate these later phases of our life with vibrancy. Many of us struggle with hormonal changes leading up to and throughout perimenopause and menopause. There is no way to bypass this journey, but there are, thankfully, many things we can do to make it a smoother one. In The Hormone Shift, Taz starts by helping you come to an understanding of how your hormones function and how to optimize them to help you feel your best. Her toolbox is wide and nuanced, but the levers she shows you how to pull are often blessedly simple. Sometimes, as she's seen again and again, just a couple of tweaks here and there really do make all the difference. Thinking back to that conversation we had years ago, I remember Taz told me that she wouldn't accept the assumption that women are done at a certain age because she still has a lot to do. Since that conversation, I've entered my 50s, and there's still a lot I hope to do. And like Taz and her patients and my friends and so many women I know, we all want to feel vital while we're doing it, even when the it is accepting an invitation to soften and slow down a bit. Taz and I both believe that we need to get rid of the idea that women expire at 50, or 40, or 60, or any age. And more so, we believe we need to embrace the new and exciting potential that exists within each of us in our later decades. A kind of power that most of us did not have access to in our younger years. I'm so grateful that Taz has given us the gift of this book. It encompasses the kind of conversation so many of us have been eager and curious to have around hormones and aging and vitality. It outlines the information about our bodies that all women should have access to long before they reach perimenopause, so that they can move through earlier hormonal changes with more ease and even look forward to, instead of dread, later ones. Another wise woman, 15 years ahead of me, told me that the final third of a woman's life is a time when she gives birth to herself, when she finally mothers herself. The Hormone Shift is a beautiful guide to that worthy endeavor, a manual to help us understand how we can best care for, nourish, and show grace to ourselves. And it's also a bright reminder of the incredible impact that we can have on our own relationships and on the wider world when we do so. Gwyneth Paltrow, founder and CEO of Goop.
Introduction: The Stranger in the Mirror. Have you ever looked in the mirror and not recognized the person you see there? The woman staring back at you may feel unfamiliar, with a body that seems different from the one you know and love. Or her skin may be duller, her hair may be thinning. There might be belly fat you've not seen before. Perhaps this view makes your mind feel clouded and your emotions volatile. Maybe you're feeling your energy is not as high as usual. Or you can't remember the last time you slept through the night. All this leaves you wondering, what the heck is going on here? And then it hits you. Ah, I must be getting old. This is the biggest lie that's ever been told to women. And it took hundreds, maybe even thousands of years to weave its components together. And today, we still believe it. I wish I could count the number of times these words, or a variation on them, have been said to me by the women I meet every day in my practice at Center Spring MD, those in my community, and others in the audiences to whom I speak. I have heard those words over and over again during the last 15 years of my practice. Whether the women are in their 30s or their 50s, they use the same line, the same language. It's almost as if they're watching me and waiting to see how long it will take for me to break and nod my head in agreement. We must be getting old, right? How else can we explain that stranger we see in the mirror? That image slowly morphing into an unrecognizable, duller version of our earlier selves. It's aging. It's normal. It's the settling into our mother's perimenopause and menopause, the time when our clothes just have to get bigger. Our muscles are expected to disappear. Those abs, well, they're a thing of the past, right? Wrong. That's the trap to be avoided. We're up against almost 250 years, if not more, of conditioning when we try to fight this old narrative. But your mother's, grandmother's, and great-grandmother's perimenopause and menopause are not your story. Honestly, it should not have been theirs either. When the average woman's lifespan was 60 years, approaching the 50-year mark with some trepidation was understandable. But when most of us are living past 80, even 90, 50 is not old. For too long now, perimenopause and menopause have been relegated to the shadows. There's something about reaching this stage of life that has been seen as admitting defeat or achieving irrelevance. It doesn't help that the stereotypical hormonal symptoms are easy to mock, the butt of constant jokes in the media, and even by loved ones. As a result, women have tried to hide those symptoms because they didn't want people to know they were now experiencing them. I think that, in their heads, women's acknowledgement of these symptoms was a confession that they indeed might be old. Here's the truth. Age really is a number. Our hormones shift throughout our lives, as they should, and how well we handle these shifts leads us to soul alignment. Many women today are not aware that there are myriad ways of navigating the hormone shifts, and that there are ways to work with your hormones to achieve balance and minimize those symptoms. That's true only if we understand that hormone shifts are transitions, transitions that come with a gift and a lesson that brings us closer to achieving our purpose. And who wants to keep that gift and lesson trapped or hidden? While I see many women in my practice every day who have fallen into that old age trap, an equal number are demanding a better way. And that's what I can offer them. With help, they emerge stronger, more confident, and healthier. They become their own advocates, and they are a testimony to the simple fact that, as research is proving, age is just a number. My story. I'm so passionate about rewriting this centuries-old narrative because I've been there too. Been in what I call hormone hell, feeling like a shadow of myself. I know how that feeling can impact your entire life, including every decision you make. If I had stayed in that space, I surely would not have been vibrant enough to speak publicly, to run companies, or even to have nourishing relationships. In 1997, I was 28 years old, and I was your classic adrenaline junkie. After finishing my studies at the Medical College of Georgia in Augusta, I took a job working in a busy hospital emergency room in Atlanta, managing injuries, infections, and full-out trauma with an insane schedule that did not differentiate day from night. There was no work-life balance. It was all work, all the time. And that meant an even harder personal life. I was burning the candle at both ends and trying to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.